Hello everyone, welcome to Chanakya Yes Academy MCQs. Let's see today's questions. Question number 1. Which union ministry organized the Technology and Bharatiya Bhasha Summit? The options are A. Ministry of Science and Technology, B. Ministry of Education, C. Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and D. Ministry of Culture. The correct answer is B. Ministry of Education. The two-day Technology and Bharatiya Bhasha Summit was organized as a part of the Bharatiya Bhasha Utsav by the Union Ministry of Education in New Delhi. The aim of the summit was to facilitate a smooth transition from the current education ecosystem to one rooted in Indian languages in line with the vision of NEP 2020 and to set the course for a technologically bright future for Indian languages in education. Question number 2. Which state's Yak Chirpi has received the geographical indication tag? The options are A. Jammu and Kashmir, B. Arunachal Pradesh, C. Uttarakhand, and D. Himachal Pradesh. The correct answer is B. Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh Yak Chirpi has received the geographical indication tag. It is a naturally fermented dairy product crafted from the milk of yaks. Chirpi is a traditional food of the tribal yak herders in the state. It is rich in protein and has been a lifeline for them in the harsh condition of the Himalayan region. Question number 3. Which country won the gold medal in the mixed double squash tournament at the Asian Games 2023? The options are A. India, B. Malaysia, C. China, and D. Japan. The correct answer is A. India. India's Deepika Pallikal and Harinder Pal Sandhu won the gold medal in the mixed doubles squash tournament at the Asian Games 2023 in Hangzhou, China. The defeated Malaysia's Aifa Azman Muhammad Sayafiq Kamal 2-0 in the final. This is the first time a squash mixed double tournament has featured at the Asian Games. Question number 4. With reference to Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, consider the following statements. 1. CTBT is a multilateral treaty which prohibits nuclear weapon test explosion whether for military or peaceful purposes. All permanent members of UNSC have ratified the treaty except China. Select the incorrect statements. The options are A. 1 only, B. 2 only, C. Both 1 and 2, and D. Neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer is B. 2 only. It is a multilateral treaty that bans all nuclear explosions whether for military or peaceful purposes and the improvement of existing nuclear weapon designs. Its negotiations started in the 1990s and it opened for signatures in 1996. It will enter into force after all 44 states listed in Annex 2 to the treaty have ratified it. Once it enters into force, it will be legally binding against nuclear testing. CTBT does not explicitly define nuclear weapons and nuclear explosive devices. India, China, the USA, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Iran, Pakistan, Israel, and Egypt have not ratified CTBT. Question number 5. PUSA 44, which was recently in news, is related to. The options are A. Jowar, B. Wheat, C. Paddy, and D. Barley. The correct answer is C. Paddy. It is a paddy variety which was developed in 1993 by the Indian Council of Agricultural Research. By the end of 2010s, it had gained widespread popularity among farmers across the Punjab, covering approximately 70-80% of the area under paddy cultivation. Farmers claim that PUSA 44 yields nearly 85 to 100 mun per acre while other varieties yield average. Let's see the concerns. It is a long duration variety taking around 160 days to mature. This is around 35 to 40 days more than other varieties requiring 5 to 6 extra cycles of irrigation. With Punjab facing severe groundwater depletion, issue of stubble burning in the state. We conclude today's MCQ here. Tomorrow we will meet with few more MCQs. Till then, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.